Tech Savvy. I'm Lee Newman, and I am the Associate Provost at West Georgia Tech on the LaGrange campus. And we're thrilled to have you back today to see more exciting happenings that are going on our campus. Today we have our high school coordinator, and her name is Lee Cunningham. And she's going to tell us all about all the exciting plans that we have to offer in the high schools and the benefits that students will receive from the program. So, Lee, before we get started with all the dual enrollment options, would you please give us a little background on you? Like, how did you get here with us at West Georgia Tech in LaGrange?
Well, I grew up in Monticello, Georgia, a couple miles from here, and I went to college at Georgia College and State University in Milledgeville. Mm-hmm. I didn't know what I wanted to do, and so I got a degree in general business so that I'd have a wide range of possibilities. And I started working with the technical college system in 2008, and I really liked the atmosphere of the school. And so,
where did you work?
At Griffin Tech, mm-hmm. and then now Southern Crescent, in the business office. And then when the financial aid position became available here in Noonan, it was closer to home, and so I jumped on that opportunity. And then a couple of years ago, the high school coordinator position became available, and I thought that would just be really exciting to be able to work with the students. That's really what I love about the job, is being kind of one-on-one with them. And so I was really excited about that opportunity and being able to work with the students to get them into our programs and see them succeed.
Well, that sounds like a good background to me. And you have a new baby.
Yes.
He's how old now?
Almost 5 months.
Not
sleeping? Keeps me busy. No.
Not sleeping. What's his name?
Jackson.
Well, I know that's an exciting new life-changing event for you. So.
Definitely.
But while we're here today, I want to make sure that we explain to our viewers what dual enrollment is, what the benefits are, the cost involved, and who benefits from students taking dual enrollment. I mean, I think everybody does, because of the cost mm-hmm. is so much less than the right. university system, and parents just need to be aware of this option.
Yeah.
We're in the process right now of coming up with a list of offerings that we will have in the high schools or provide for the high schools to choose from. And we had a meeting yesterday, and we came up with a potential list. Now, obviously, this has to go through the approval process, and we'll have some adjustments to make. But tell us what we're thinking about.
Well, some of the programs we're looking at offering would be shampoo technician for cosmetology, welding, nurse aide, criminal justice, and mechatronics
right.
That would be a couple of new things, and maybe fire science.
Right.
So those are some things that we're looking at for the new year. We currently have welding and nurse aid, and they're both successful programs at our LaGrange campus. We have good interest in those, but we'd like to add some more offerings. Dual enrollment is kind of like an umbrella term where they can earn high school credit and college credit at the same time. So they usually come to our campus and they're taking the college classes and get both of the credits for it. So it's a big perk that they can go ahead and get their either a technical college certificate while they're in high school, or they can earn credits to get a jump start on their high school with some core classes through the Excel program. And with the Excel program, any of your general core like English, math, biology, psychology, those are all offered on our LaGrange campus or online. Mm-hmm. And so that's a great opportunity for them to jump start in their college careers if they're pursuing an associate's degree or bachelor's degree. And those will transfer to any Board of Regents schools in the state of Georgia. We have an agreement with them. So that's a really big perk. Saves a lot of money in that way, because the funds that are used do not count towards their HOPE cap hours. And so that's another benefit, so that they still have their full HOPE funding if they're eligible once they graduate from high school.
Eligible, like a student in high school, what are the eligibility requirements to be in a dual enrollment class?
Well, they do have to submit an application with us. This is the application packet, and we have these around at all the high schools, or they can always come to our campus and pick it up. But they have to submit the application. There's not an application fee for high school students doing dual enrollment.
Okay.
They do have to take the COMPASS test or SAT or ACT, and they have to score at a certain level on any of those tests to be able to be in the program.
Well, right now I know Lori Basham is scheduling tests at all the high schools.
Correct.
And I think she goes back two or three times to make sure all the opportunities there for the high school students.
Right.
And is this test a real booger bear?
No, it just takes time, and the students that take their time with it and don't rush through the test, they generally do okay on it. And then if they take it early enough, we still have time to retest them. There is some retesting options. We have some Compass boot camps that we offer, so they can attend one of those or complete the information online, and then that allows them to be able to retest. So that if they take it now, we still have time to retest them to be able to get in for August for the fall semester. So it's important that they go ahead and take the Compass test as soon as possible if they haven't had the SAT or ACT.
Right.
And they can see, I think, the CTA coordinators or CTA office at their high schools to be able to get signed up to take the test at the high schools.
Right.
If they don't get in with the testing at the high school, they can always come to our campus as well and take the Compass test there.
So there's not a maximum number of times they can take it?
There is. Well, they technically can only take it once a semester.
Okay.
But if they test now during spring semester, like February, March, then they can test once school's out for the summer. They'll be able to take it. And plus, that would give them time to do the Compass boot camp to get brushed up on whatever they need to brush up on to be able to retake it and still get in the class in August.
Well, I'm sure we're going to have boot camps scheduled all during the summer if necessary.
Right. So. We usually do have them several times at each campus.
It sounds tough, but I think it's a real benefit. Mm-hmm. I mean, the higher you make on the test, the better you are.
Right.
And so it sounds too easy. It just sounds way too easy. So the student at this point in time in January can say something to their counselor like, I'm really interested in criminal justice. What do I need to do to get into a dual enrollment class? And then what's the next step?
Well, the counselor would need to make sure that they're on track for graduation, that they're able, that they have that room in their schedule to be able to take the classes. And then they would sign the student up for the Compass test or give them the application and kind of give them those steps that they need to do, which is submit the application, take the test scores. We also need a copy of their birth certificate and or driver's license to show their lawful presence. That is a new requirement that we have to have. And then there's also a form with the application packet that the counselor will sign off on and say, yes, I recommend this student for the dual enrollment program, and then that's kind of how we get them signed up for the class. And then we'll have an orientation session during the summer for those students that are registered, so they can come and find out everything they need to know about starting their class.
Well, it just sounds really simple. So I think about my children, of course, long graduated from college, but had they had the opportunity to take dual enrollment classes in high school, for an example, I always thought web page design would be something good at that point. I mean, we're talking 5 to 7 years ago. They could get a certificate in web page design along with a high school graduation, and then when they got out of high school, they would have a skill. Like, they could build web pages for anybody and get paid for it to help them with the cost of college.
That's correct.
So what we're offering, you said the criminal justice, Shampoo Tech, okay, they could get a certificate in Shampoo Tech and actually be able to work in a salon upon graduation from high school.
And also all of our certificates that they can earn during high school, if they want to come back to us afterwards, they can build upon those and earn more certificates, a diploma, or even an associate's degree. So with the Shampoo Tech, they at least get a few of the classes out of the way for the cosmetology diploma. So then they would have less time to be able to finish that diploma. They wouldn't have as long to take
They'll
to complete the diploma.
Much further along than the first semester
freshman. So that
freshman
gets them closer to getting into work with a diploma.
Right. All right. Now the criminal justice, the connection on that, I think it was crime scene fundamentals and
just criminal justice
fundamentals. We have just recently signed an articulation agreement with, was it University of West Georgia or was it Columbus?
I think we have something with both of them.
Both of them. Mm-hmm. So that if they get a certificate and end up getting a diploma, they possibly could get their AS degree in criminal justice. And then all that would transfer over to a university system.
Correct.
And they could get a bachelor's.
Mm-hmm.
And they could get a semester or possibly even two semesters out of the way in high school.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So they would be done a year sooner.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay. This is just, it sounds like such a wonderful opportunity.
It is. It really is. We have some students that have already taken things and have gone into college once they graduated high school as a sophomore. So taking their first whole entire year of college while they're still in high school. So that is really what is like, yay, when you really see that you're doing a good job when you have those students that excel that way.
Well, I mean, when you compare the cost of our tuition along to Board of Regents, right. Like ours is $85 a credit hour, mm-hmm. and local community colleges and area colleges are like $185
right.
a credit hour. So that right there saves so much money.
It does. It really does save a lot of money. And with the funding, depending on what program they're in, there's HOPE grant funding and the Excel funding that helps cover a lot of their tuition. They do have a little bit of tuition sometimes to pay and fees, but we do waive a lot of the fees for high school students. So our high school students don't pay as much as our traditional students do as well. So even though our tuition's lower, our fees are even lower for the high school students. So that's another perk as well. So it is a very beneficial for them to not have to pay as much while they're in high school and go ahead and get some of those credits. For our certificate programs, we also purchase all of the books for those classes, so they don't have to purchase books.
That is.
With our core classes, they still have to purchase those, but with the certificates, we issue those out and they turn them back in at the end of the semester.
So it's used
that saves a lot of the cost for the student as well.
Well, Lee, we get to take a break now.
Okay.
We will come back and we'll talk about the costs and how much it costs for the student to be able to participate in these dual enrollment classes. And then we'll go into a little bit more detail about what happens after they complete dual enrollment program. So we'll see you back in a few minutes. Welcome back to Tech Savvy. We have Lee Cunningham here today, and she's going to continue with we're going to talk about all the benefits and who's involved and rules and regulations for dual enrollment. And of course, as any case with any of our episodes, if you have questions or want more information, just visit us on the website, which is www.westgeorgiatech.edu. westgeatech.edu. So Lee, let's start back up. What is something very important that we need to make sure our viewers know about dual enrollment?
Well, one thing is their ages for what they have to be in the program. They do have to be either a junior or senior and 16 at the start of the semester to be able to be in our programs. With some of the programs, like nurse aid, they do need to be 17 by the time they start their clinicals. Because they have to take a background check for that program, so they have to be at least 17. But generally, just a junior or senior and at least 16 years of age to to be in any of our programs. So with that, they need to really start preparing while they're a 10th grader and taking the Compass test and getting ready for that so that they can start either as a junior or senior.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, I think in most cases when you're in the 10th grade, you really don't want to take another test, or you're just not taking everything serious, and you really certainly haven't thought about what you're going to be doing in 2 years. So what's important is that you just really need to take the situation seriously and go on and do your very best, because right. Like criminal justice, I guess you could start earlier.
Right.
In juniors, and then that would mean you would be out of college a lot sooner than your classmates.
Right. And if you're a 10th grader and you don't know what you want to do, it's a great way to try something out. If you're thinking, you know, I might be interested in that, it gives you time to try something out now rather than 4 years into a college before you make that decision.
Right.
So it's a great, if you're thinking about nursing, try the nurse aid program, because you're really going to get a lot of hands-on and really see how that field is. And it's better to decide that now as a junior or senior if that's really what you want to do, rather than further on down the line and wasting money
so, and time.
And time.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. With that CNA, isn't there a new rule in Georgia that in order to get into the RN or the LPN classes now, programs, you have to have the CNA first, right?
I know it is with the RN program. Mm-hmm. We have it at our West Georgia Tech and several of the surrounding colleges do as well, that you have to have either your CNA or your LPN license to be able to even apply into the RN program.
Mm-hmm.
So it's definitely a good one. Another perk for doing it in high school, check that off the list, that you've already got that certification, and then you can focus on your core classes to be able to get into an RN program somewhere.
Well, I know that there's always an opening for those CNA students, those mm-hmm. graduates. We never have any problem placing them in,
right.
Whether it's a nursing home or a hospital or a doctor's office or a clinic. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, guaranteed get back, you know, started work right as soon as you get out of high school.
Right, and that's what a lot of our students do, is they get the certification, and then if they do want to pursue a registered nursing or an LPN, they still have this that they can fall back on and work while they're still going to school,
mm-hmm.
and so they're able to earn that money as well. So with most of our programs, job placement is definitely not an issue. If they want to work, they can find a job. So.
Well, we've got lots of job openings out there, and it sounds like to me we've addressed a lot of the needs from industry with these particular dual enrollment classes.
Right.
And, of course, as with all of our programs, we have our work ethics grade.
Mm-hmm.
We give a technical grade and we give a work ethics grade at the end of each semester,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
What are some of the characteristics that we cover in our work ethics? It's attendance, punctuality, appearance,
mm-hmm.
attitude,
mm-hmm.
And all these things are so important in work ethics. I mean, they learn in class, they learn with us the importance of being at work every day or at school every day, but
right.
they understand the importance.
Right.
And that is probably the one thing that I hear over and over again from industry nowadays, is they just don't understand. All we really want them to do is be here 5 days a week.
Right.
You know, and ready to work.
Mm-hmm.
We can teach them how to do everything else. So, okay, we understand now that you can get involved with these dual enrollment classes as 16-year-old or junior and then a senior. Hope is part of this. Tell me,
right.
How does Hope work in all this?
They just have to apply online for the Hope Grant. We have the instructions in the application packet. It's a simple application. It's just a matter of going online and filling out a simple little form. The main requirement is that they've been a resident of Georgia for the last 12 months and that they're a U.S. citizen or eligible citizen. But that's generally the only requirement for our high school students.
Is that at Georgia 411?
Yes, www.gacollege411.org.
Uh-huh.
And they can apply online for the Hope Grant or the Excel program. Both of those applications are online. There's two different applications depending on what program it is.
What is the Excel?
The Excel is for the core classes. That's for your degree level core classes that they can take. So that's a separate fund of money. It used to fall under Hope, but now they have their own state appropriated funds for that. So there is a separate application from the Hope Grant that they have to do.
Mm-hmm.
So it just depends on which program they're in as to which application that they fill out online, but both of them are very, very simple and don't take more than 10 minutes to complete online. And mm-hmm. that gets their financial, that comes to us directly, and we can get their financial aid on their account from that.
Okay, now this Excel, the classes are different. Like, you've got the HOPE grant that covers the technical, which would be the right. CNA, the criminal justice, the welding, right. all those. But Excel, and it's
A-C-C-E-L.
That is, all right, English, get your English 101 or 1101, get your math 1101 or whatever the very, right. the core classes are, that do transfer to university system. Right. So, and I was fascinated about the list of classes we have besides the Englishes and the math. We have history and we have art appreciation. We have music appreciation, psychology, biology. Mm-hmm. All of those core.
Even Spanish is now included in that. Speech, a wide variety of those core classes are covered under the Excel program.
So, I mean, in two semesters, if they take two classes, they could have actually four
correct
core mm-hmm. classes out of the way
yes.
for college starting in, and right. then if they went in the summer and took two more.
Right. Summer's a little bit different, but it's still a possibility.
Right.
The funding is just where it's a little different, but they can still take classes during the summer as well. With the Excel program, they can take one class or they can take up to four classes. Pretty much for every class they take with us under the Excel program, it's one or two less that they have at the high school, depending on what credits they need. But if they took four classes, they could have, you know, almost a full year of college done in the two semesters. We also have the Move On When Ready program, which is not as widely popular, but it's a full-time college program. So our high school students that come to us and full-time enrolled at the college. The reason it's not so popular, or we don't have as many people in it, is because they have to make sure that they complete all of their high school graduation requirements through that program, and sometimes it's hard for us to make sure that they can get all of those classes and credits with us. But we still have some students that do that as well. And with it, it's just a different form rather than the Excel and the HOPE. It's just a different form for the funding. But it does pay for pretty much all of their tuition and fees through the Move On When Ready program.
Right.
But the only obstacle we generally run into is if they need a certain science, a particular science or something like that, that we don't offer here. And that was usually the only barrier to be able to get students as a Move On When Ready.
Right.
But they can take four, even five classes under the Move On When Ready program with us.
Per semester. So basically they come in at 8:00 in the morning and leave at 3:30 in the afternoon or whatever.
Maybe not even that much. I mean, our classes, the core classes, only meet 2 days a week. And so some students are only coming to us 2 days a week and take all of their three or four classes within those 2 days.
Mm-hmm.
So they may not even be here a full day. I have a lot of students that, you know, they try to get their classes in the morning, so then they work in the afternoons, and mm-hmm. have part-time jobs and things mm-hmm. like that. So it's very flexible with our core classes as to scheduling. We have pretty much any time during the day and evening classes.
Mm-hmm.
And we have students in any of those pretty much. So. And they can take online classes as well with the core.
But they're sitting in the class with adults.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And we treat them just like they're college students on our campus. And nobody really knows that they're high school students. I do let their instructors know, just because I have to collect grades a different way for our high school students.
Uh-huh.
So the instructors will know, but they really don't remember. They treat them just like anybody else sitting in their class.
Well, that's such a good... That gives them a chance to mature,
right,
and be better prepared for when right. they do get out of high school. I think that's an outstanding option. I do. All right, it's something else I thought about is with these classes that we're offering, like the criminal justice will go on to a bachelor's degree, welding, and then the mechatronics we're working on to start up in the fall, and that's been very, very a major interest in our local industries, because mm-hmm. it gives the student or the graduate, if they complete the program, all kinds of basic fundamental manufacturing skills in hydraulics, pneumatics, robotics, PLCs. It is an unbelievable opportunity for students that pretty sure they're not going to go to college and want to go to work in one of our local industries, but we've had industry buy-in on those, so
right.
I'm excited about offering that, because mm-hmm. that'll be so good to improve and enhance our workforce in yeah. our area. Mm-hmm. All right, we're running out of time, Lee. What else do we need to tell our viewers? I mean, basically, if you're listening to us and you're interested and you've got students or friends that have students that don't really know what they're going to go into when they get out of high school or really kind of bored with high school at this point, this is a good opportunity for students that need to find something to be interested in to start early. And everything we teach is very experiential and hands-on, and most of the times that's the best way to learn. So if you have any questions, if you're interested in finding out more about this, first of all, you might want to check with your counselors in high school, but second of all, call us. We'll be glad to fill in any information that we can and be glad to show you around and I'll see what all this, you know, we have out there. But Lee, thank you very much for joining me today. And will you please come back?
Yeah. Sure.
And let's talk about this some more. And as things change and improve and increase,
yeah,
come back and talk to us about it. Okay?
Sounds good.
Thank you very much for having
thank
us.
Thank you.
And thank you very much for joining us for this episode of Tech Savvy. I'm Lee Newman, and we'll see you next time.